Hello.
And hey. In our last video, we talked about structures in TwinCAT.
Today, we want to deepen the topic a little more. We would like to talk about the alignment in TwinCAT 3 and in this context also about the attribute pack mode.
Furthermore, we will talk about the operators new and delete, as well as the enable dynamic creation attribute and explain how to allocate memory and what a dynamically created structure is. Let's start with the alignment. In our last video, we already mentioned that the memory in TwinCAT 3 is 8-byte aligned. But what does that mean? We want you to understand how the size of a structure and its memory location comes about. That's why it is important to understand the alignment rules in TwinCAT. In our example, you see three variables, Babaji, Baboji, and Bababai. Bababai has the data type byte, he requires 1 byte of memory. Babaji has the data type int, he requires 4 byte of memory space. And Baboji has AL word as data type and requires 8 byte of memory. Together, they hang around in a structure. If we have a structure like this, the memory location is specified by the member with the largest data type size and by the alignment. In our case, this is Baboji. If the largest data type is smaller than or equal to the alignment of the system, the memory location of the structure instance is equivalent to a multiple of this data type size. If the largest data type is larger than the alignment of the system, the memory location of the structure instance is equivalent to a multiple of the alignment. After this is clear, the structure takes up the amount of memory space as is specified by the size of the largest data type in the structure and by the alignment. If the largest data type is smaller than or equal to the alignment of the system, the memory space taken up by the structure instance is equivalent to a multiple of this data type size. If the largest data type is larger than the alignment of the system, the memory space taken up by the structure instance is equivalent to a multiple of the alignment. These alignment rules may result in implicit padding bytes. This means it can make a difference how you place your variables in a structure. If Baboji is the first, followed by Babaji and at the end Bababai, the structure has a size of 16 byte. Behind Bababai, 3 filler bytes are inserted to reach a limit corresponding to the largest data type, divisible by 8 byte. Now the members change places, starting with Bababai, followed by Babaji. Between them, 3 filler bytes are inserted to reach a limit corresponding to the following data type, divisible by 4 byte, and after Babaji, Baboji takes a seat. Bababai and Babaji don't get along with each other, that's why Baboji decides to separate them. He swaps places with Babaji. Now 7 filler bytes are inserted behind Bababai to reach the limit corresponding to the following data type, divisible by 8 byte. After Babaji, 4 filler bytes are inserted to reach a limit corresponding to the largest data type, divisible by 8 byte. As you can see, the size of our structure varies. This is caused by the adding of implicit padding bytes, due to the 8-byte alignment of TwinCAT 3. In TwinCAT, we can use the SIZEOF operator to determine the number of bytes required by the specified variable x. The SIZEOF operator always returns an unsigned value. The type of the return variable adapts to the detected size of variable x. In a 1-byte alignment, all of the structures would have the memory requirement of 13 bytes.
And that's the point where we should talk about the attribute pack mode. This pragma defines how a data structure is packed during the allocation. You insert the attribute in the line above the declaration of the data structure with the following syntax. Open curly bracket. Attribute. Quotation mark, pack mode. quotation mark equals quotation mark value quotation mark closed curly bracket. The inserted value defines the pack mode. The values 0, 1, 2, 4, and 8 are possible. If your pack mode is set to 0 or 1, all variables are assigned to byte addresses, no memory gaps occur. If your package type is 2-byte aligned, then the 1-byte variables are assigned to byte addresses. And the 2-byte variables are assigned to addresses that are divisible by 2. The maximum gap that may occur is 1 byte. The 4-byte variables are assigned to addresses that are divisible by 2. The maximum gap that may occur is 1 byte. And the 8-byte variables are assigned to addresses that are divisible by 2. The maximum gap that may occur is 1 byte. If your package type is 4-byte aligned, then 1-byte variables are assigned to byte addresses. And the 2-byte variables are assigned to addresses that are divisible by 2. The maximum gap that may occur is 1 byte. 4-byte variables are assigned to addresses that are divisible by 4. The maximum gap that may occur is 3 byte. And 8-byte variables are assigned to addresses that are divisible by 4. The maximum gap that may occur is 3 byte. If your package type is 8-byte aligned, the 1-byte variables are assigned to byte addresses. And 2-byte variables are assigned to addresses that are divisible by 2. The maximum gap that may occur is 1 byte. The 4-byte variables are assigned to addresses that are divisible by 4. The maximum gap that may occur is 3 byte. And the 8-byte variables are assigned to addresses that are divisible by 8. The maximum gap that may occur is 7 byte. For all package types, strings are always at byte addresses. No gap is created.
It can be that you won't see a difference in the memory split between the individual modes. This depends on the structure configuration, declaration. Means, it can be that the memory distribution of a struct with pack mode 4 is the same as with pack mode equals 8. There is another fact worth knowing. If structures are grouped into arrays, bytes are inserted at the end of the structure so that the next structure is aligned again. The attribute pack mode can help you to keep the size of your structure smaller. But you should keep in mind that if you access a member in a 1-byte aligned structure, the access could take longer. For example, if you ask for 8 bytes beginning at address 9, the CPU must fetch the 8 bytes beginning at address 8 as well as the 8 bytes beginning at address 16, then mask out the bytes you wanted. On the other hand, if you ask for the 8 bytes beginning at address 8, then only a single fetch is needed. Keep that in mind if you intend to use this attribute. There is another pragma, which we want to present to you. The enable dynamic creation pragma. This pragma is required in order to use the new operator with function blocks or DUTs. This operator is used to create, for example, structures dynamically. That's why we thought it would be a good idea to talk about the attribute and the operator at this point. In our video about arrays, we already mentioned that it is also possible to create dynamic arrays with the new operator. Now we will show you how you use. You can either allocate memory statically or dynamically. If the program allocates memory at compile time, it is static memory allocation. If the program allocates memory at runtime, it is dynamic memory allocation. So as you can guess from its name, a dynamically created structure allocates memory at runtime. If we want to create a structure in TwinCAT 3 dynamically, obviously, we need a structure. In the declaration of the structure, you insert the attribute enabled dynamic creation in the first line. The new operator can only be applied to function blocks or DUTs from libraries and to function blocks or DUTs with the attribute enable dynamic creation. If the interface of such a function block or DUT is changed, TwinCAT issues an error message. Now we declare three variables in our main. Two of the type bool and one is a pointer. We will talk about pointers in detail in our next video. For now, all you need to know is that during runtime, a pointer saves the memory address of objects such as variables or function block instances. Our variable is called pstru-stru and the pointer points at our structure. The two bool variables are called strunew and strudelete. Now we write a short if construction in the implementation part. If strunew and pstru-stru equals 0, then pstru-stru equals new, stru-stru, strunew equals false, end if. The operator generates an instance from the specified type, in our case this is our structure. Then it returns a pointer to this instance. Next, TwinCAT calls the initialization of the instance. If the memory allocation attempt fails, new returns the value 0. The syntax looks like this: new, in brackets the type, and if it is a scalar type, TwinCAT sets additional the optional operand. If you set a length, the operator generates an array of type and length. The length defines the number of elements. This only works for standard data types, for structures it is not possible. The dynamic memory is allocated from the router memory pool. When the program has no more use for the variable, it can return the memory block to the router memory pool with the delete operator. Delete releases the memory of dynamically created instances. To demonstrate it, we write a second if instruction. If stru delete then delete, pstru-stru, stru delete equals false, end if. The operator delete has no return value, and the operand is set to 0 after this operation. Let's log in and start the program. We set stru new to true. The value of pstru-stru changes. Now we set stru delete to true and pstru-stru is again 0. This recycling makes very efficient use of memory, so keep in mind that you can use this operators not only for structures.
Okay, thank you Ajnan for explaining this to us.
You are welcome, as always.
If you liked what you saw, feel free to hit the like button.
Yes, and if you don't want to miss new videos, subscribe to our channel.
We also want to invite you to visit our company's website and the ekvip LinkedIn profile. Have a great time. Bye.
Bye.